time to break some hearts because we're discussing DLC, the combat pack for MK11. Hey, what's going on, everybody? My name is Dynasty. Got for y'all today another Mortal Kombat You Love video, and pretty much at this point in time, we know like 99.9% of the MK11 roster, courtesy of the massive leaks that took place over the last like week and a half, 2 weeks. And this is what it's shaping up to look like based on everything we've seen so far. 25 character base roster, 2 unlockable characters, plus Shao Kahn being your pre-order bonus. Now, the reason why we also say this is legit because this got leaked like a week before the screenshot surfaced of the actual in-game roster. And yeah, this thing is interesting because it even includes Sindel and Nightwolf as part of the Combat Pack 1, something that has kind of been swept under the rug lately. And I figured, hey, let's just discuss the DLC now because we're also finally approaching April. The game launches in the middle of April. Chances are history's going to repeat itself and they'll probably reveal every DLC character like the first week of April because it's they did back inside the MKX combat pack. So I'm assuming it just makes sense to do it now because not only do we know like the majority of the roster, but we're already approaching April. I just want to get my thoughts out there before this gets revealed. So with that said, let's break this down and let's get into it. So keep in mind as well, there's going to be 6 DLC characters in the Combat Pack DLC that is like 110% confirmed to be happening. So, kicking things off with my wish list at the number 1 spot, so that goes to a character that I'm still shocked wasn't on the base roster of this game. Rain. Nobody expect Guy to not make the MK11 roster because alongside Noob Saibot, he was way up there for MKX, like, DLC request hype. Everybody wanted Noob back then. Everybody wanted Rain. Everybody wanted Fujin. Those 3 characters seem to be, like, a lock for the MK11 roster. And when NetherRealm Studios didn't give us those characters as DLC dating back to MKX, many just assumed, like, okay, well, they're probably not DLC because they're saving them for MK11. And I could live with that. Everyone could live with that. And it's funny because now it's like, wait, what? Rain's not on the main roster? And it's still shocking to me, because even going back to the Mortal Kombat